Hey everyone, I'm Robert. A year and a half ago, I got a mechanical keyboard that changed everything about how I work. This device didn't just improve my typing. The thing is that at first, I had some issues trying to adapt to a layout that I wasn't used to, but this sent me on a journey of learning about keyboard remapping and customization that opened my eyes to a completely new way of using my computer. I have talked about this in the past, but here I want to give you an overview of what my setup currently looks like, and I also want to share with you a user-friendly option that can help you achieve something similar. In few words, my keyboard now is like a command center that feels like an extension of my thoughts. I don't have to hunt through menus or remember shortcuts to do things quickly. Every action that I want to perform flows naturally from my fingertips. For example, Superwhisper is my go-to dictation app. I placed its main trigger right where my fingers rest. I just press D and F together. What if I need to hide the recording window while holding down and dictating? A quick tap with my pinky does that. What if I want a larger view? Then the next finger handles it. I release, and my text is in the recording window. I can switch between different dictation modes just by holding down the A key, which stands for AI, and using my left hand alone. Getting to where I am now has not been a straightforward path at all, with lots of turns and having to do a lot of research along the way, but now I can easily integrate any new app that I discover quickly into this system, and I can start doing things fast. The impact on my productivity and daily workflows has been incredible. That's exactly why I want to share more of this with you. I know presenting something like this can seem intimidating at first glance, but my hope is that with this video, you can have some practical ideas to start with. And maybe it even inspires you to explore this direction yourself. Like many of you, I began by trying to master keyboard shortcuts to speed up my computer work, but I kept running into the same issues, customizing shortcuts until I ran out of options, ending up with awkward key combinations that were hard to press or remember. Automation tools like Alfred, Keyboard Maestro, or Better Touch Tool are super helpful in this same department, but the real breakthrough for me came when I discovered keyboard remapping. The Nocfree Lite, my keyboard, came with Vial, a user-friendly and very powerful tool that allows you to configure it. But I needed something that will work everywhere, even on my laptop. That's when I found Karabiner, which lets me customize any keyboard system-wise. Let me explain to you some of the basics of my setup first. I think a very good starting place is the caps lock key. This key sits in a perfect spot, but most people rarely use it. Many power users convert the caps lock into a hyper key. This means that when you press the caps lock, the system will interpret that as if you were pressing shift, command, control, and option. But I took it further than that. I think that the best way to avoid running out of keyboard shortcuts is not using them at all. So instead of just combining modifiers as much as I can, at least, I make it perform specific actions directly. For example, when I press caps lock and return, this opens a small floating window on my browser. Let's open a website. If I press caps lock and return again, this hides the window. I use an application called Yabai for Windows management. This allows me to, for example, be on a separate space working on something else. And anytime that I press the same key combination, it brings back my browser just where I left it. It's a powerful tool if I'm working on a project that requires browsing and extracting information that will end up in different apps. I also have several Alfred workflows that I trigger directly with caps lock. For example, caps lock and comma activates a workflow that keeps my Mac awake. I can also press caps lock and G to open another workflow that contains some favorite folders or files. Cap locks M to filter through all the menus of my current application, and so on. I've got a lot of simple actions like this, but where it gets really interesting is that Karabiner lets you create layers. You can think of layers as different modes for your keyboard. For example, I have a layer for Cleanshot X, which I use for screenshots. So if I press caps lock and C, that puts me in that layer. And what comes next is the action. In this case, let me press V to take a floating screenshot that I can move around or resize. And this also stays up if I switch to a different space. Now, if I press Caps Lock and C again to enter that layer, I can press another layer to take a screenshot and directly start annotating. Let me drag this into a Dropover shelf. This is another very powerful app that I can control with a layer on the letter D. So let me press Caps Lock D. And now let's say that I want to upload this file to the cloud. Can you guess which letter should I press for that action? Letter C, correct. Now, let me open my Dropbox folder. I have a lot of different folders ready to open under letter F, which stands for Finder. So let's say that I want to move that Dropover file to this Finder window. How do I do that? I simply enter my Dropover layer, caps D, followed by F. Most of these apps or automations that I'm showing you are triggered either by Apple Script or by URL schemes, so I don't ever run into conflicts with other shortcuts. I also don't need to press complicated modifier combinations. Let me show you Cleanshot documentation, that app for screenshots that I just showed you. There's this page that explains all of these simple commands that control everything directly. Okay, I know that this might start to seem like a lot to take in for some of you, but here I just wanted to show you what's possible so you can understand the main idea. I have thought about creating guides or tutorials for this, but the truth is that the Karabiner setup can get pretty complex. I need to write my rules and modifications in a format called EDN. A utility named Goku turns this into something that Karabiner can read. And if you look at my configuration JSON file, it has grown to over 30,000 lines. So it's definitely not for the faint of heart. But here's something very exciting. Recently, I found LeaderKey, a free and open source app that makes something like this much easier. It's a very user-friendly way to create a simpler version of my setup. Let me show you how it works. If you open LeaderKey's preferences, you can set up your main keyboard shortcut here. While you can set any combination of keys, I still suggest that you go for a simple Karabiner modification for this. This kind of setup is not complicated at all, and in fact, let me show you how to do it. You open Karabiner Elements, and in the tab where it says Simple Modifications, you can select For All Devices. And then we can set it so that when we press our right option, the system will interpret it as a function key. I'll put it on F5 for this example. Now I can go back to LeaderKey and simply press my right option key. If you go to the documentation of LeaderKey, there's a few more examples of Karabiner modifications that are relatively easy to set up and maybe more convenient for you. This is just to trigger this app. Now, if you press the shortcut you have chosen, you will see an icon that tells you it's ready for your next command. You can pick different themes here that change the look of the dot, but my favorite is the subtle breadcrumbs style. Using LeaderKey feels similar to how I use my Caps Lock. You can create actions at the top level, for example. Let's try something simple, making the letter G open a URL, and let's open Google. Now let's test this. I press my right option, then G. Perfect. How about making a group for Cleanshot? Let's make it on letter C. Then we have an action in there for annotating, so letter A, one of those URLs that I showed you earlier. Okay, let's test right now. My LeaderKey shortcut first, letter C to enter the group, and letter A to annotate. Perfect. Now you can start adding more URLs to trigger different Cleanshot features in the same way. You can create groups for all sorts of things. In my Karabiner setup, I have a layer that I use to control my Superwhisper for Alfred workflow. I have a layer for opening some of my most used Finder folders, a layer for Dropover actions. The sky truly is the limit. Now, the specific setup with LeaderKey doesn't quite meet all my needs. I could need multiple LeaderKeys around my entire keyboard. Like I showed you at the beginning of the video, I have a layer that appears when I press D and F together. Then all of these other keys perform different actions. I also got W for Windows management. If I press W and R, I can resize windows by pressing keys on the other side of my keyboard. WF to move focus, T for text transformations, and many more like that. I also need to be able to set application-specific rules so that the same key can act differently depending on my front app. And I also have a bit of a complex setup with my right command key for switching or activating apps. But that's a topic for a whole other video. I don't think that LeaderKey is trying to replace Karabiner, but it's perfect for anyone who wants an easy way to create a palette of commands to open apps, folders, websites, trigger automations, and so much more. If you use Alfred, Raycast, or Keyboard Maestro, LeaderKey can make you even faster. You may struggle a bit at first to get used to it, but it's just a matter of developing some muscle memory. Oh, and this kind of setup is great for ergonomics as well. Keeping everything close to your fingers helps prevent strain if you spend lots of time at your computer. LeaderKey has this great feature that I really liked. You can set it so that when you press your keyboard shortcut after a specific amount of time, a small window will pop up showing you all the actions that you have assigned. Seeing this made me a tiny bit jealous because I thought that it was very well implemented. The truth is that I have so many different actions on my Karabiner setup, and even though most of them are very intuitive to me, sometimes I still need a little reminder. So I started to think, okay, how can I do something like this for my own setup? After looking around, I was surprised to discover that Better Touch Tool has a feature that allows you to create a web view that can be sort of an overlay on top of your screen. With a little help from AI, I was able to come up with something that I really liked. So now, if I press and hold my caps lock for a few seconds, there you go. These are my main actions on this key. Those that appear darker represent sublayers. I have other top-level keys, like I was telling you, so I can press and hold W, and there's everything related to Windows management. The same applies to every other layer or sublayer. I'll be giving you links to everything that I have mentioned here. My keyboard, apps, and Alfred workflows that I have been showing you. I will even give you the link to my Karabiner EDN file for Goku or the WebView that I made for Better Touch Tool if you want to check those out. I am still trying to think about how to explain or teach you a bit more about Karabiner because it really is incredible. This video is just scratching the very surface, but I was excited to share with you about this alternative that I think may be good enough for many of you. I would love to hear your thoughts, questions, or suggestions. No matter which tool you choose, Karabiner, LeaderKey, or something else, I just hope this gives you some ideas to transform your keyboard into something more powerful. And by the way, guys, if you are interested in checking out the Nocfree Lite, the keyboard that I use and love, please consider using my affiliate link in the description. It will cost you nothing extra, and your support helps me create more content like this. Don't forget to sign up for my newsletter to stay up to date with what I'm up to. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon.